Era la noche antes del día de la vida, en una galaxia muy, muy lejana.
Tiene buena pinta. Árbol, comida, decoración...
Reuniéndose, los héroes estaban para celebrar el día.
¡Que sea una capa! ¡Que sea una capa!
¡Es una capa!
A Rey la aventura llamaba, y que sería rápido, pensó.
¡Hala!
Pero una llave al pasado de la galaxia, allí encontró.
¡Perdón! ¡Maestro Luke!
¿Pero qué haces?
¡Hi, Anthony! ¡I'm Berta, from E Cartelera, Spain!
¡Hola!
¡Hola!
I am very proud. Look, my book, can you see?
Soy
Sergio, La Historia Desde Dentro. Can you say it in Spanish for me?
La Historia Desde Dentro.
And how do you say soy C-3PO?
Soy C-3PO.
C-3PO. Gracias. Muchas gracias.
You're welcome. So Anthony, this Christmas special is not the first one in the Star Wars saga. We already watched one in the 70s. I was wondering if this new one has anything to do with that one.
I am happy to say nothing at all. Because you know that the first one is in like the Chamber of Horrors. That it was a program that went a little crazy. Now, a lot of people think it is so bad that it is good, okay? Me, I just think it was so bad. But this one, apart from the big connection is Life Day, because as you know, on Life Day, Wookiees around the galaxy try to get back to their home planet of Kashyyyk, where they can celebrate this celebration of life. Other people have Hanukkah or Christmas or Diwali or something. Wookiees have Life Day, oh yes. And they try to get home to be with mom and dad and the cousins and all that kind of thing. And this time it is the same, but this time it's in Lego. And you can see behind me, my favorite Star Wars gift, remembrance, is my big Lego C-3PO. So I'm quite into Lego, but I don't play with it, but I enjoy it.
So, of course, C-3PO is a part of that Life Day because he's one of the members of this huge family, because Star Wars is about family. And C-3PO, it's been a part of that family for more than 40 years. So I was wondering, what's the best thing about playing a character for 40 years and what's the worst thing?
The worst thing is his voice. I am C-3PO. It's actually quite hard physically to do because he is very tense. He's very unrelaxed. And so, producing that voice in my throat and so on my chest is, if you do it for very long, it becomes very tiring. The best thing is that I can still do that voice after all these years and, you know, still be there in all sorts of places like Star Tours and the adventures continue in Disneyland and all sorts of cartoons. And of course this one, the best thing is to have this character I love exist in my realm, that he's a good friend of mine. I don't want to be with him all the time, but you know, on the whole, my life is much better for knowing him. And I think quite a few fans out there would feel the same. And so it is great that he is there, even though he's not alive, because he's a machine, you have to remember, he is part of Life Day.
This special is a lot about laughing with Star Wars. And I was wondering if you think it's going to conquer those that think about Star Wars in a most serious way, you know, that takes Star Wars really seriously.
Yes, it's a very good question. Sometimes when people take a subject seriously, they lose their humor, they think too much about it. Star Wars is a wonderful story, and it's a story we love so much that we can now, through the power of Lego, we can tease it. We can poke fun at it. We can be funny about it because we love the basic story so much. It gives us the ability to relax and just laugh. And I think even people who really take things seriously, the dark side, the fight, you know, against the empire, they can take this holiday season to just relax and say, that was kind of funny. Then they can go back to worrying about the emperor and so on.
Thank you so much, Anthony. It's been a pleasure.
It's a real pleasure. And thank you for the language lesson. Adios.
Gunta, Gunta, solos?
¿Quieres disparar primero?
Después de ti.